in this second Cameroon. Race in the semi-final EF race.
Tunisia.
We have competitors from Cameroon,
Zimbabwe,
Tunisia and Zimbabwe, Kazakhstan, three from the Africa continent,
Chinese
and
Taipei.
Kazakhstan and Chinese
Attention.
Taipei. There wasn't enough time to introduce them all because of the lateness of the finish of the last race, but I can do that for you. Starting on the far side in lane one for Cameroon is Paul Etier and Ndumbe. In lane two, representing Tunisia, the man in red there is Ayman Mejri. In lane three for Zimbabwe, James Fraser McKenzie. In lane four for Kazakhstan, Vladislav Yakovlev. And in lane five for Chinese Taipei, Minhui Wen. There's a trailing boat, as you see in that last shot there, which shows the people who decide on the rules of the race and make sure that everybody's in line and in order. Two hitting the front at the moment, boats three and four. Four, I think, for the moment, which is Vladislav Yakovlev, a 19-year-old from Kazakhstan who trains at the Tematau School of Rowing. And the yellow boat in the centre of your picture, the colours depicting the colours of Zimbabwe. This is an interesting man, James Fraser McKenzie, only 19 years of age. There's a Kazakhstani. And the background for Zimbabwe there, when he was training back home in Zimbabwe on the river, he encountered hippos, crocodiles, black mambas, and would you believe, a dead donkey on one day in one race. A Tunisian there, Ayman Mejri, is 23, a student, coached by Chokri Ben Miled. And it is Zimbabwe in front of Kazakhstan on this near side in lane five for Chinese Taipei is Minhui Wang, a 26-year-old. He's 6 feet 2 inches tall, unusually tall for a resident of that country. Trains in Sydney, Australia. And that is Fraser McKenzie, our leader from Zimbabwe. And he could have a huge future in this sport, just 19, remember. So people do not mature sometimes until their mid to late 20s. In terms of the rowing abilities, the one who is struggling most of all is the Tunisian, but it is a stroke rate of only 29 for the Cameroonian, Etienne Ndumbe. Total focus required on the job in hand. Get the rhythm going, don't worry too much about whatever everybody else is doing alongside you. You can see the different styles here, particularly of the competitors from Kazakhstan and Chinese Taipei. The discipline required is just incredible. Most of these competitors get up at 6 o'clock in the morning to get out onto their local river, whichever rowing club they perform for. The double battle named Fraser McKenzie is in charge of the race at the moment, but only just. And there's a good effort being put in here from Paul Etienne Ndumbe. Although he comes from Cameroon, the 28-year-old rowed in Rouen in France. He's just slipped back again a little bit now, and the closest to the leader from Zimbabwe is Minhui Wang from Chinese Taipei. Zimbabwean flag is a mixture of colours, greens, yellows and reds. I've heard about them being quite strong in cricket. Now they're looking to find a winner in rowing. These two semi-finals, by the way, will be followed by, with all due respect to them, the more important quarter-finals, in which we'll see the superstars of the sport. With the body art is going to the front for Chinese Taipei, 26 years of age, 6 feet 2. He comes to the National Taiwan College, but trains sometimes in Australia. It's a race between these two for the moment. It's Zimbabwe and Chinese Taipei out in front, lanes 1, 2 and 4. Still in the race, but over on that far lane one, Paul Etier and Dumbe. He's giving it a good go. He's putting in a terrific shift here. Still, he's actually edging ahead, I think, at 1500. No, not quite. It's the camera angle that can be deceptive. But he may just be. He's certainly the one who was pushed up now ahead of both Tunisia and Kazakhstan. As we see from this angle now, it is still Zimbabwe and only just leading from Chinese Taipei. In fact, our computer tells us that Chinese Taipei has taken up the lead in 5:40.2 from Zimbabwean Fraser McKenzie. It's a test of real character and resolve now for him to see if he can hit back. Once you've ceded the lead, it's very hard sometimes to do that, but it looks as though he's managing pretty well. Zimbabwe and Chinese Taipei locking horns here on the river, or on the lake as we should call it really, at Eton Dorney. Each lane is 13.5 meters wide, 3 meters deep the water. Once again, it's all about the angles that we look at from our cameras, and it suggests to me that by an absolute hair's breadth, Zimbabwe lead from Chinese Taipei. With Kazakhstan probably in third. The crowd, you can hear them now, becoming even more excited as they sense the victory is going to go to the Zimbabwean James Fraser McKenzie. And this is a notable effort from the 19-year-old. He's certainly not there yet. There's more rowing to be done. And coming up on the rails, so to speak, is Vladislav Yakovlev, another 19-year-old from Kazakhstan. The race is between these three. And a very good race it is, too. Just holding on. Fraser McKenzie. Closing without question is Yakovlev. Equally there is Minghui Wang. These three now are going to contest it, with the other two from Tunisia and Cameroon out of the race. Who's going to sneak this one? It's a tremendous finish, and I think it's Chinese Taipei that do it. And how disappointing for the Zimbabwean. He trails home in third after all of that. Well, an extraordinary effort put in there by that man. Minghui Wang, the 26-year-old, shows the strain, but what a victory that he stole at the end there, with Yakovlev coming in second, and Fraser McKenzie will be so disappointed not to have been able to hold on, having literally led the race from first. He was leading there, look, and he suddenly lost it on the last couple of strokes. And how close was that? A fingernail between Chinese Taipei and Kazakhstan.
Next on the course is the repechage of the women's.
Well, it was a very good race. And it is a victory in 7:33.18, so a 0.11 of a second, the difference between first and second.